I'm chatting here with Ken Keisel, who worked on Knightriders, and you were a zombie on Day of the Dead?
I worked on Knightriders Creepshow and Day of the Dead.
Great. And you told a really great story at your panel about George Romero helping you out a little bit, and I was wondering if you could just talk about that a little bit more.
Oh, I'm delighted to talk about that. Yeah, when I started working on Knightriders, I was working through a fellow named Larry Winterseller, and Larry ran Mayer's Costume Shop. So we had spent a weekend, four of us, sewing 90 pieces of medieval garb for Knightriders. And then he needed somebody to come up to the set with him and repair the costumes as they got damaged. So Larry and I were on set for several weeks, sitting in the back of a van, and the folks would come up with their damaged costumes, and we would stitch them back together, and we would clean them at the end of the night and then have them ready for the shoot the next day. And I was only on set for maybe a week or so, maybe less than that, when George came walking up one day, and he had a sandwich with him, and he handed me the sandwich, and he said, who are you? And I said, my name is Ken. I'm here with Mayer's Costumes. And he says, how old are you? And I said, I'm 16. And he said, first he asked me, he said, where are you from? And I said, I'm from Upper St. Clair. And he went, because Upper St. Clair is a very nice neighborhood. And he said that, I was expecting to say Braddock or Homestead or something. He says, because I grew up in the slums of Philadelphia, and I was going to put an arm around you and sympathize with you and tell you things are going to get better. And he says, yeah, Upper St. Clair, geez. He says, but where do you go to school? And I said, I go to Seton LaSalle High School, and which is a Catholic high school in Dormont. And he said, how do you like that? And I said, I hate it. And he said, it just so happens. Well, first he said, what do you want to do after you graduate? What do you hope to do in the future? I said, I'd like to be an actor. And he said, an actor? And I said, yeah. He said, you don't want to be a director? And I said, no, I'd actually like to be an actor. And he says, it just so happens that I'm connected with Carnegie Mellon, and Carnegie Mellon and Point Park College just started a high school for the performing arts over in Oakland. And if you are interested, I would be happy to give you the information on that if you think you might want to transfer and do a high school for the performing arts. And I'm like, yeah. So about an hour later, he, true to his word, he comes back with an index card with a guy's name and a phone number. He says, give him a call. He says, I'll give him a call too and let him know to expect you, and you'll prepare for an audition, have a good audition ready, and meet with them. They're over in Oakland on McKee Place Road. And so sure enough, I called, and the guy had already heard from George, and he was like, yeah, come on down. So I went down and gave an audition, which I thought was a pretty crummy audition, and I got right in. So I did my my junior year and my senior year of high school at McKee Place Performing Arts High School, which was a feeder school for CMU, and then I was working on Creepshow before I started my college applications, and George asked me on Creepshow, he says, how are things going over at McKee Place? I said, they're going real well. And he said, you're going to be applying to CMU for college? And I said, hopefully. I mean, it's a tough school to get into. He says, I'll put in a call for you. And he said, he gave me the name of the person to talk to for an audition. And I called them again, and I got an audition. I thought it was crummy. And sure enough, about 6 weeks later, I got a letter of acceptance from CMU. So I ended up doing 3 years of CMU. And it was great because it led to doing 7 movies, 5 of them in Pittsburgh. And about 60 shows, and that's all goes back to George.
It's amazing. You hear a lot of people talk about, it seems like anybody who interacted with George has some sort of story of just him being a kind and generous person. You always hear that sort of thing. You and I were on the same mall tour earlier today for the Dawn of the Dead, for the Monroeville Mall here in Monroeville for the Dawn of the Dead tour. And you mentioned that was your first time doing that. What was the experience like for you taking the tour here?
It answered a lot of questions I had about the mall, because it occurred to me when I came out here about a month ago to talk to Kevin, who runs this convention, that I had not been in the mall since we filmed Flashdance here. So it's been 40 years almost since I was last here in the mall. And I remember when I first moved to Pittsburgh in 79, I had my dad drive me out here because we had just seen Dawn of the Dead in the theaters the year before. And it still looked very much like it did in the movie. And there are things that walking through the mall you can't see. And I remember thinking, you know, where was this filmed and where was that filmed and where was their apartment and all of that. And this tour finally, 40 years later, answered all the questions that you can't get just by walking around the mall. And where was the alcove that they boarded over? So that it was really good because, you know, here we are all these years later and I'm finally getting answers to those questions I had back when I first came here.
Thanks so much for chatting with us, Ken.
Absolutely. It was a lot of fun.
Cool. Thank you,
sir. Sure, thank you. I was off.
Your motivation is flesh.
Our motivation is not getting cut out of the movie.